Hello and welcome everyone to part 51 of the Marvel Confederacy Let's Play for Empire Total War with Darth Maul. We continue where we left things off a last time. Managed to take Tripoli, wipe out the Barbary States. We have a lovely bit of income, nearly 100,000. We've got 92 at the moment. 8k away from 100,000 income per turn, which would be just bloody insane. So, we are on the cusp of our operation against Austria. And again, you can find the straw poll link down in the description for the vote. Because I still don't think we're actually going to have everything in place to begin it this part. I think part 52 is going to be the start of it. So you've got one final time now, if you haven't already voted. Operation Austria, Operation Austria Annihilation. Austria is just winning it on the votes at the moment for the operation name. So feel free to go check that out. We have got these guys assembled in forts along the border, ready to begin our invasions. The various battle groups are assembled, and we're just sending the last few forces into position. So for these guys that we're sending around, this is a full infantry spam stack, so they need cavalry and artillery, and we can get, I think, yeah, both are utterly here, so there we go. Take out 6 units and replace them with that. More than enough to get them by. Can upgrade the artillery if we want to. We still need to do plenty of upgrades all over our territories. First of all, we're just going to go back to India. And you guys mentioned a very clear way, which I hadn't even thought about, for taking out the Dutch in America, which is just to take them out in Europe. Very simply, just take them out in Europe. Their provinces in America will rebel, creating their own faction, which should be much easier to deal with. I'm hoping they won't keep all those stacks, basically. Right, we're just upgrading all those to, again, make these guys earn me even more money. Trinidad and Tobago, we don't have any more upgrades on your gem mine. Oh, that's to Spain, in fact. We literally just have the sugar warehouse and the port, which we will upgrade. That's spent a lot of money. Right, go back through here. Check everything that needs to be upgraded. The Ashram at this point, no. Not unless it's the absolutely last thing I need to do. We've got the steam workshop and everything like that that need upgrading. Spices. You guys need everything upgrading. You're going to have your port upgraded. Wow, that money does not go that far. There we go. That technology, we should be able to research it now, surely. Yes, we can, finally. So it's either 16 turn, damn, or 9. Let's get it working on... Well, I guess you'd be the best one. How long is it going to take you? It's going to take you 12 turns to research that. So I might get you started on that, in which case you go and finish off that, which is only going to take you 4. So we're only losing out on a turn there. You've got 3 turns left to go on those top sail, or top gallants, rather. Then we'll probably get you on... Well, we can't go for that because we'll have to wait a turn. So we could get you started on that, which is 9. 9 turns for that, and then we'll just have 2 more bits of tech to research, which we need just 1 university going through, which we'll just keep this one. It's our best one. In fact, this over here, can we get, do we have any other gentlemen in the region that we could send over there? No one, like, he's the closest, so no, probably not, unless we've got other agents that I've just totally forgotten about. Probably got quite a few gentlemen that I've forgotten about. We have a literal crap ton. Ah, this guy. Yes, we're sending this guy over. Well, we've been trying to for, like, turn after turn. Let's do that quickly. Let's just grab a little Zebek. Pop him in the port, because you can help my research of everything. So it's currently taking you 9 turns. The research here. No, sorry, it's taking 12 turns. I lie. Because we just put you on a brand new one. Now let's see what it changes you to. 11. That'll do. Right, we need to check where I've got all these scholars, because I don't think I've been moving them that much. You're up here at that university, that's fine. If you're not in a university, you're there. You're there. You're in that one. I don't know, maybe I have got them. I just don't have that many because I don't have that many universities. That's probably why. Okay, that's all cool then. Well, at least we've doubled you guys up, so it'll be a little bit faster. So, that's all we can do for now. I'm not looking to spam out any more Hindu warriors from here. I think we most certainly have enough armies. Now, enough forces. Oh, I've already got these guys here. But then they're probably keeping the repression. Oh, no, actually, I could probably take you all out. But then you're just a bit of insurance in case Sweden decides to suddenly do something with its forces. Christ. Right, three armies then will be here ready on the border. One to go straight for Podolia, two for Moldova. And again, it's not just about taking the settlements, it's about dealing with the armies that are in these lands as well. But these four over in Tripoli, we're sending via ship. And we need to get them ready to land. Who owns this territory? I mean, this is also... So this is the one time when we'd actually abuse the military access. But we're not going to run right up to their settlement. We're just going to get these guys into position. We could have them in position off the coast, but I don't want to risk being hit by a Dutch navy. Although there's no point putting these guys in anywhere, in any ships, until next turn at least. I'm just going to get rid of the proof settlements fortifications because I'd much prefer not fighting in a fort. But I don't think we need to leave any repression. 15. Yeah, we can actually take all of our forces out and we'll still be fine. So we're going to take this thuggie. I'm going to scout with him this turn. We're going to go drop him up into our landing zone. If the lag doesn't kill us. There we go. Drop him up there. Got a thuggy over here so we can see, but behind enemy lines, Croatia is currently undefended. They've actually got a couple of our armies held back. Right, so let's pull these guys back to the port. Then we're going to sort of ship by ship get these guys into position. And so I think part 52 is going to be the one where we launch all of our forces at Austria as hard as we can. Engineer school still upgrading. But we can get the 24 pounders. So what else do we get out of this? Just enable extra research and prestige. Because we've already got the large mortars and 24 pounders. So I don't know. I have to wait another turn. More cavalry to leave behind to look after everything. Plus this army is just chilling. Because we need another army on the border here at least. We've got our forces to push that way. We need another army here. Well, in fact, we need another two armies, so it's why we're bringing these guys along. And this army is ready to go pretty much as well. In fact, you're spamming out all those artillery pieces. Nice. Nice, because then we've got these guys, these cavalry units to go in with this army. Three units of artillery for here. Splendid. Okay, we're nearly there. We're nearly there, guys. This has been a huge build-up. I'm not sure if this build-up's been more than the one against the Ottomans or the Russians, to be honest. But I think it's probably not been that long, actually. Let's end the turn. It's probably not been that long because we already had a lot of pieces in play in those areas. Oh, I should also say, guys, because I mentioned in the last part, I was bidding on an iPhone in an auction, hoping that no one else would have spotted it. Unfortunately, it seems probably quite a few people did spot it. I didn't win the auction with my measly bid of £40. It was very hopeful. But I was curious to see how much it actually gone for. So I actually emailed the auction house and said, you know, I'm interested, how much did this lot go for? How much did that iPhone sell for? It sold really well. It sold for £310. I mean, for the auction house's point of view, anyway. £310. So the person that bought it, you know, that's nearly, I mean, it's probably about £100 cheaper than buying it direct from Apple still. But, you know, I'm not looking to spend that much money on an iPhone, you know, just off chance that I could get a killer deal at an auction, basically. So I'll keep looking for insane tech deals. I've never really thought about auction houses before, but could well be a good way of getting one, but I think that unless there's a huge number of phones and very few interested buyers that day, you're not going to get that lucky. I mean, it'd have to be some really obscure auction house in the middle of nowhere that just happened to get a huge, I don't know, administration drop of loads of old phones. Well, not old phones, but loads of unopened phones or something like that. I kind of thought that I might get away with this because it was the only, it was like in a lot full of furniture, and I thought that people glancing through the catalogue would just be like, ah, furniture, whatever, okay. Ah, yes, nice, the Dutch have taken out France at Genoa. Come on, you've just got to go take Corsica. Get yourselves on a ship and kill the French. Okay, with that in mind, I'm now actually going to consider building those armies back in my homeland, ready to take out the French colonies that will spawn in India. Oh, come on, United Provinces, come on. This, I still will come and destroy you guys after I'm done with Austria, but you have played perfectly into my grand scheme. This is smashing. Absolutely smashing. But yeah, so I wasn't successful with my auction bid. Alas, I wasn't that hopeful, to be honest. £40, too good to be true to get away with it like that. But it's always next time. And again, not necessarily that I need an iPhone. Just thought, well, for £40, might as well try. Ba, 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 ba. Come on, United Provinces. You had to have a big think there, didn't you? Come on. Please go and kill France off. Please. That would make my bloody... I know they've got like three armies there. One, I would have thought surely they must... Oh, wait, no, the thing is, I would be thinking they must surely be dying over there. No, of course, they've probably got... Well, they've got their Indian colonies, which is probably earning them a fair bit. And they do have, like, Louisiana, I think, in America. They don't have much land in America. They lost a fair bit. But, these Indian ones will probably be keeping them afloat. So their armies might be all right. But I hope the Dutch just swarm them and kill them all. Kill them all. It's actually quite interesting to see the AI kind of work to my master plan, which is just smashing. I'm gonna have a sip of tea. I feel like I need to give like an evil chortle a laugh. Thank you, Dutch. Thank you. Also, oh my god. I was saying in the last part how I really liked the suggestion for an operation name against the Dutch of Operation Amster Slam. Well, you guys have surpassed yourself. Operation Deaderland was suggested, which I really like as well. So I think those are going to be the ones to vote for the Dutch campaign, but I won't hold a poll for that until after we've completed the Austrian one. Or perhaps while we're initiating the Austrian one, every part where we're trying to kill Austria, that'll be in the description. But it won't be yet. So, yeah, Operation Amster Slam, Operation Deaderland. Obviously, Netherland. Netherlands. Deaderlands. Deaderland. I love it. I love it! We're still a strike here. It's just because someone told me I've actually, and I forgot about this. Apparently, I have a... Yeah, this. Literally, this thing that I keep repairing. I think. It's a, converts the population to Islam. It's a madrasa. Right. These guys all ready to go. Workers on strike. Yeah, yeah. Recruitment report. New town emerges. Ah, cool. Nice. Way up in Russia. You're part of this one, aren't you? How are you doing in terms of Hinduism? Yeah, it's doing all right. Let's get some money instead then. How's my income as well? Oh, mighty. Not quite. It's dipped a little bit, but that's fine. Fleet arrives. Ah, yes, we brought these guys over to knock the Dutch off, didn't we? So we could have a little naval scrap. I haven't fought one for a while. Who wants to see Lionheart fail at a naval battle? I do. We'll do that in a minute, though. because that'll probably take the rest of the time of the episode, and we don't want that just yet. I've got other bits to do. Sorting out moving these armies to my borders, my front line. Do 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 do. Man a man a man a man. Ba 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 ba. Oh wow! The cannons instantly jumped into this nearby army. Nice. Well, we only want three of them, if I'm perfectly honest. Grab you guys, pop you guys out. Ah, oh, damn, you guys can't cross this turn. That's fine then. They're happy. Artillery round to here. We're building one unit of cannons. Start going with that. You guys, though. Oh, you can't, I love how you can't go across there. It's ridiculous. You guys need to lose three infantry. No, just two. I might throw. Oh, no, these guys got the war elephants. I've got some melee troops. Nah, it's fine. We'll just overwhelm you with infantry, infantry, infantry. Right, that's the last of the armies moving up. So we've got three more armies to push through here. So that's all good. And then we are ready. They're nearly ready. The clamor for reform is mainly because of this uni as well. If I got rid of that, then we'll be all right. But this is my best university as well. My best university. So we can't do that yet. Right, you guys. Are you all replenished up? You are. So you can start getting yourselves down here. We're not going to pop you into tips because they can land. Well, the thing is, we're going to have to land them the turn before we want to invade. Oh, these guys need a little bit more replenishment. Tripoli is perfectly happy, though. I'm not worried about a war with Spain right now, so I'm not going to leave any units there defending because it's not worth it. We need all these forces on the front line. We could throw in some desert warriors or something. So we shall see. We shall see. Yeah, getting them into position. And then we'll put them each on a ship. The turn before we're going to attack, because we want them fresh to launch. We're going to actually land on this little peninsula bit here. Look at that. Everyone land here, and then boom, boom, boom. Right, Dutch, please go and kill the French. I know they've got like their best forces. Really do have their best forces here, but please, come on. You guys can spam them with dragoons and howitzers. Come on, you can take them. I reckon they almost won't, though. It would be... I'm not sure if the AI has it in them to work out how to do that. Hope so. I hope so, because we are on the cusp of everything falling into place. And I'll wait for your suggestions as to whether or not I start building my armies up now, to be honest. I mean, I doubt they're heavily defended. They've got little tiny forces here. East India troop. But, I mean, Calcutta is probably stacked. I can send a scout in, I guess, or something. We'll spend all the money next part. But for now, let's have ourselves a naval battle. Your Majesty. Let's upgrade you to a suitable admiral. And attack. Boom! So I've got 4th rate, 4th rate, 4th rate, 5th rate, 3 4th rates and a 5th rate. They've got 1 4th rate and 1 5th rate. I mean, I'm probably still going to cock it up. Let's, not going to lie here. But let's give it a go, because we haven't had a naval battle for years. Years and years and years. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Ugh. Which da 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 do we? Right. Deployment, deployment, deployment. We've got the wind with us. We might as well. I think, yeah, I'll group. Oh, crap. I'll group you guys. Like so. We'll have a line. And then we'll have you on this side. Because you're slightly faster. We'll fast forward it as well. The plan being that we can just hit them with all these guys. This one can get some early shots off because it's faster, or it should be. A little bit more maneuverable at least, being a fifth rate. Try and get the first shots off with it. This guy's sailing into the wind, so we should have the advantage. Yeah, so I'm going to send my fifth rate after their fifth rate, basically. Let battle commence, men. They're going to get a good broadside off on my fifth rate. I retaliate. And here comes my fourth on their fourth, which we should fire at exactly the same time, I would have thought. We'll start firing anyway. Yeah. Okay. Ooh, I lost a few more cannons than they did. Start pulling you around so you can keep firing on them. And also I want to try and go for that ship there. Still got the wind with us. And I'm going to swing this one right round. Oh yeah, we've done lots of damage to them there. I just need this ship to really swing round. Oh, this one's been caught out on its own too much. Isolated, I shouldn't have done that. Because I've done no damage to it, pretty much. Whereas over here, we have managed to achieve that pretty well. I'm going to turn this ship around like this because they're going to come around that way. Likewise here. Which means that this one will get a shot off on that fifth rate. Don't know why these guys are wavering. Surely it should be this one that's taking a fair bit of fire. Firing on that one over there now. Again, not much damage, I assume. Not close enough in the range. Hold. Hold. Okay, I'm going to get this one keep turning around, actually. I've completely forgotten all the advice you guys probably gave me earlier in earlier parts about naval battles, by the way. So, my apologies on that. And I'm going into the wind now as well. It looks like it's sinking though. Or is that just the way it's catching the wind like that? I'm going to swing this ship round because this one's facing a bit of trouble. Pull this ship round so we can catch it on the other broadside. This one's going to chase it though. Bring this one round. You're trying to get onto my weakened side now. These guys back into the action over here. Come on. Ah, you must be taking on water so badly on that side. Yeah, it took a lot of damage. That's why it's leaning so badly. We can get this ship round over here. I don't think so. I think I'm about to lose that fifth rate probably. Hit fast forward now. Ah, yeah, this one's gone. Come on. Ah, that one's gone. Nice. Surrendered. Right, now I'm going to send my fourth rate up against their fifth. Yeah, both of our ships have surrendered, so we're one apiece. They've taken out a fifth, I've taken out a fourth. So I've come out of the trade-off a little bit better. I mean, at least that kept that fifth out of the kind of confrontation with my fourth rates. Got the wind right now, although I am blocking my other ship getting involved in this. Just gonna sail up, try and get around it. Think. I'm trying to work out the best way of getting this ship involved in the fight, because these guys are just coming closer and closer, so I might as well allow these guys to keep on firing, as long as they will. We'll see what happens when they look like they're about to clash. We're okay, stop here. Swing you round as well. You should be able to fire now. I just swing around a little bit. There we go. Both my ships can fire. Swing you round. Allow you to keep firing. We need to bring this ship in close before we let it fire off. They're wavering slightly now. That's to be expected. Come on, you guys must be able to fire soon. Come on. Nice. Back, turn that way. Let's catch the wind again. Strong side showing once more. I would have liked it if Darth Maul had added it in as a feature. I'm sure it could have been ported over, but from Napoleon Total War, I really like the fact that you could repair your ships in a naval battle. But you know, they'd never be as strong as before, but it would help heal up them temporarily. So because you'd literally be patching, you know, leaks as I would assume, you know. Battle repairs would have been made during battles at sea, which I really like that feature. I thought that was a fantastic addition to naval battles. Really enjoyed that. I'd love to see CA give naval battles or Age of Sail another go, which is why I'd love to see like a Victoria Total War. I know we're moving on to like steamships and everything bit more, and definitely like an Empire 2 is what I'd love to see at some point. I know I mention this all the time, but because it's what I like. Oh damn, son. Might of Maratha's navy. Now able to go toe-to-toe with the Dutch, although we did outnumber them, so maybe not toe-to-toe. But who cares? As long as the job is done. Oh, I'm not going to be able to turn, am I? They're trying to force me onto my weakened side. Thankfully, these guys keep shooting them down. Oh, you're weakened, sir. Keep turning. Bring you guys back into the fight a little bit, because you're ways out from it. Being covered perfectly by these ships at the moment. Come on. Another broadside. Yeah, come on again. So low. Going so low. Let's do it. Come on. Kill them all. Bring them down. following along. Right, now swing round, swing round, swing round. They're going down. They're so weakened on this side. I'm surprised they either haven't sunk yet or exploded. I'll hit the powder keg. That might be enough. Ah, come on, I just want to see... Ah, was that not enough? Damn. Well, we can quit the battle now. A decisive victory on the seas. Huzzah! Only lost one ship. Zing. Lionheart takes back the seas. I'm a sea lion now. Is that more walrus? That's more walrus, isn't it? What noise does like a sea lion make? So we both lost one ship, but that's fine. It was the fifth rate. We just need the fourths. That's it. Flee! Flee for your lives! Ha! Well, that is where we're going to wrap up for now, guys. So I do hope you've enjoyed. Don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. Vote for Operation Austria or Operation Austria Annihilation down in the comment in the description. Use that link there. Don't vote in the comment section. Vote via the link in the description. And I will see you with the next one, where hopefully 52 is going to be the start of that operation against Austria. So until then, don't forget to comment, subscribe, follow me on Facebook and Twitter, take pride and join the Legion, check out my affiliates and sponsors, XMG, Green Man Gaming, and GT Omega Racing. Until the next one, ciao for now.